Hey everybody, I'm Gardner, the Linux Gamer. I don't think I've been this kind of excited about anything for such a long time. It's like I'm 10 years old again, and I know Christmas is just next week. What am I talking about? The Linux Game Jam 2017. The response from you guys has been huge. As of recording this, we're counting 93 people who've joined the Game Jam. It's gone way beyond my wildest expectations. Let me just look this up here. 94 now. That's awesome. I've heard from some people that this is their first jam, or that they're not really programmers, but they wanted to join up. And that's so cool to me. A game jam seems like a great place to get started. In that spirit, I wanted to make a list of a few tools that might help you out. So here's a high-level overview of four open source development tools that can get you started. Godot, Godot. It's a visual editor made for game development that lets you do a ton. It supports 2D and 3D graphics. It uses a Python-like scripting language. You can even do animation within the editor. The engine is mature, robust, and from my experience, stable. You can publish your games for Linux, Mac, Windows, and mobile too. Plus, the editor is available for free through Steam. Love. Love is a framework for developing games in Lua. The framework provides API callbacks that make setting up, rendering, and updating your game's state much easier. I have rather limited experience with Love, but there are several rather popular games that were developed using this framework, including Move or Die and Oh My Giraffe. Check out love2d.org for more information. Phaser. Aside from the allusion to Star Trek, Phaser is a framework for games built using Canvas and WebGL. Yeah, that's right, browser games. They count, okay? Phaser provides a JavaScript API that takes the hassle out of rendering and game state management. There's also Mighty Editor, which is a browser-based visual editor for Phaser games. Phaser is probably what I'm going to use for my submission to the jam. I've been meaning to dig into the nitty-gritty of this framework for a while, and I can think of no better excuse than to learn as I go. So Godot has its own built-in code editor, but you'll probably need one for Love in Phaser. Sure, you might use Gedit or Vim, but I'd recommend VS Code, also known as Visual Studio Code. It's an elegant tool for programming. I use it the most for the web design I do as a side hustle. VS Code is highly extensible, with plugins that can check syntax on the fly, drop in boilerplate code, and can even autocomplete functions, variables, and anything else. Now keep in mind, these are not the only tools that you're allowed to use. You can use any engine or tool that you'd like, and I'll tell you right now, I am so excited to see what you guys are gonna make for this event. But what do you think? Did I miss your favorite game development tool? Let me know in the comments or on Twitter at TheLinuxGamer. You can also support the work that I do over on Patreon. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you subscribe to the channel and hit that like button. And as always, thanks for watching. Linux, Mac, Windows, and others. Oh my God.